So I was looking through Mario Maker's most popular levels, and found this one that was played over 3 million times. And to beat the level in as little time as possible, I spent hours looking for shortcuts and getting the world record time. And I'll beat a harder level for this video too. At the start, you're meant to land on top of this thwomp to jump to another thwomp, but I save a fraction of a second by going under the thwomp and wall jumping off its side. And coming up, you're supposed to spin jump into this pipe, but you can actually save time by doing a glitch super jump to gain height faster, which is done by doing a spin jump and canceling the jump at the same time. I jump through the gaps without slowing down, and I throw this box so I can use it to go into a pipe. So the next few parts of the level don't have as much time saved, but the optimizations I've done so far add up to about a second saved, and there will be a shortcut near the end of the level that saves another 2 seconds. And to save time, you have to pull off a pretty hard trick. Anyway, after going through the pipe, I blow up a brick so I can use this bullet blaster as a platform, and now I kick this shell to hit the on-off switch so the spikes keep switching. And I wall jump up the spikes as fast as possible so I can enter the pipe as the spikes deactivate. So this second segment of the level is essentially an auto-scroller, so I'll speed it up a bit, but there's a shortcut later on to skip some of it. So the intended way to do this section looks like this. You spend time jumping off the shell from the clear pipe, and the lava brings up this spring for you to take and use for the final trick. You would throw the spring ahead and use the box as a platform to get enough height over the spikes, and you enter the pipe. But instead of that, I can simply shell jump off the spike to skip the waiting, and now that I've done that shortcut, I normally have to wait a little longer for the lava to bring the spring up, but instead of waiting and carrying the spring, I can just bounce off of it to get up faster. And now for the hardest trick, I perform a glitch super jump off the box midair to clear the spikes, and I save about 2 seconds because I didn't have to wait for the lava to bring up the spring. And finally, there's one last part where I jump off the switching spikes, so I carefully time my jumps to stay alive and speed across them. And now I do a tight jump to land on the flag, and I beat the level with the world record time. So this next level has no ground and constant tricks using a boot power-up. In the beginning, I throw this P-switch under Bowser Jr. so it stalls him and I can jump off of him, and now I throw this Bob-omb so I can bounce off it with the boot. I use the small hop from the boot to line up a shell jump, and I slide off the thwomp for another midair jump, and here, I grab the P-switch and bounce off the spring, and then I can jump off some falling enemies. Now I activate the P-switch with this enemy so it sets up a shell jump, and I hop with the boot for a spring jump, and I do a shell jump in another boot. I launch this shell so I can jump off it as I enter the boot, and in this part, the boot lets me continuously bounce off the Mecha Koopa, so I precisely throw it to line up some midair jumps. And for this last part, I grab the POW and shell jump with the big shell, and I use the POW as a platform and set up another shell jump, and I run off the falling POWs and throw the spring for one last jump and complete the level. So usually whenever I achieve something, I like to celebrate by putting something up on my wall symbolizing my achievement. Last video, I mentioned we were close to beating this channel Jam Jammy's Nursery Rhymes and subscribers, and since then, we have defeated them. So to commemorate our victory, I put Jam Jammy's on my wall.